Thank you, yourself, man. Where is it? Yes, while I know the finish, okay. Welcome on board. Today we'll be talking about some interesting things that you need to know while sizing your solar array system, especially if you want to power things that draw a little bit amount of current. So we'll be talking about some interesting things. I will show you from the practical perspective. So what you need to know, this is my buck converter, this is my charge controller. You need a charge controller to ensure that the power that is coming to your battery is safe, and it will charge it properly, and it will not overcharge. When it is fully charged, it will cut off. This is my circuit breaker to avoid any fire outbreak. It will cut off the system. This is the inverter here. It's 1000 watts. Look at it. 1000 VA. This is my battery. You can clearly see it. 12 volt, 40 amp. I'm using 13.8 to set the charge controller. So this is a deep cycle battery. Please do not use car battery. Look at an example of a car battery. This is 75 amp. But no matter how good this battery is, it can't give me half of the power of this, because if the highest I can get from this 75 amp is half. So if you divide 75 by half, it's less than 30. It's around 30, but this one is 40. This is deep cycle. Please go for deep cycle battery. I'm currently powering my TV. Look at it. There's no any power anywhere. Look at it. The wall is empty. So let's go into the calculation so that you understand some key things you need. So before you go into this, you first need to know how many power is your appliance drawing. So for the case of my television and my decoder, it's drawing about 220 watts in 1 hour. So electricity is calculated in kilowatts. So you can use, I will make a video in that in future, how you can know how many watts of power your appliance is drawing. But for now, we are learning how to size our solar power. This is that. So let's go with the calculation. We are having 120, that is the hour, that is watt in 1 hour. So if you multiply it by the number of hours, which is 4, you will have 480. So we need a solar power system that is around 480. Look at it, that is around 480. So since we need a system that is around 480, that is our battery. The battery is 12 volt. If you multiply 12 times 40 amp, it can be more, but it should be within at least. So if we multiply, we'll see 480. So this is the maximum power we can draw from our battery, since it is a deep cycle battery. Then if we do the calculation, we'll do the breakdown. We want to charge this battery within 5 hours. So if we divide 480 divided by 5, which is the number of hours, we are going to have about 80. So we need a solar panel that is around 400, about 80 watts. So from this, within 5 hours or 6 hours, our battery should be fully charged. So that is how you do the sizing. You know your battery, your power, you know your battery capacity, then you divide your battery capacity by the number of hours that you want it to be fully charged. If it is 5 hours, good and fine. If it is 6 hours, good and fine. If it is 7 hours, good and fine. All will give you, to determine the size of the solar array, solar panel power that you need. So the solar panel is 21 volt, 2.5 amps. So if you multiply it, you have around 80 watts. So I'm using an 80 watt solar panel. So this is it. That is how you know how to size some of these things, because it's very, very important. If you don't know, you will just be doing trial and error, and you will not see that your battery is not getting fully charged well. And it can vary from dry season to rainy season. So within dry season, when the sun is at peak, I get the best. So the extra 2 hours that the sun will be is for additional this in the event that the sun is not too bright that particular day. Then there are a host of other calculations I will be doing to give you a breakdown of some of these things that you need to know. Please do not use a UPS. UPS will not give you this efficiency you are looking for. And if you are using this type of inverter, please do not use appliances that are electromagnetic. Those appliances that use coil inside, because it can damage the inverter within the shortest possible time, because it's not designed to handle current flyback. Thank you very much. Let's enjoy our jam as we move further to other things. I never ask you to dance. Thank you very much. Enjoy yourself. Let's move the ministry to the permanent side. Do yourself a good job. Thank you.